Hi, welcome back to my channel. Today I want to share with you my unboxing of my order from Sterling Inc. That's Bruce. He is headed for the front door. He is doing okay. I still can't tell if the new chemo pill that he's taking is helping him too much. His face is still red on his muzzle. But he has an appointment next week. And hopefully we'll get an update of what the oncologist thinks. But I also have beside my Sterling Inc. order, my cousin, Hobonichi, and then as well as my traveler's notebook, standard size. This is the diner edition. And then I have the standard, this is the weekly notebook, I think is what they call it, or the weekly calendar. And I use this to track my meals, steps, exercise, well, hints of exercise in here. So I placed my order for Sterling Inc. on September 15th. It's the first time I've ever ordered from them. And I waited on a specific day to place my order for these two items. And then once I placed my order, I placed it on hold because I also wanted to get a clear cover on cover for my for one of the planners. And she was releasing that in October. And actually the clear cover released on October 18th. So I went ahead and bought my cover. And then I asked them to release my order. And so then they shipped it on October 23. And then I received it on October 28. So as you can tell, I ripped off the shipping label off the box. And now let me just move these out of the way. And so this is what the inside looks like. Set this aside. I don't know what I did with. I'll be right back. I have my trusty box cutter. If I can get it to cut. So that looks like my invoice. So I'm gonna set it aside and, oh, maybe not. Okay, it's not. So let me move this guy out of the way. So I ordered the A5. Let's see, this one's called the A5 Vertical Full Year Common Planner. It has 520 total pages. There are 368 blank pages. And then this will be the N1, which is the traveler's notebook standard size. It's the compact full year horizontal. This one has 272 pages with 120 blank pages in the back. So let me set my paper aside. Okay, and then it looks like it comes with a freebie. And this is what you get. And a thank you card. Let me, I guess I'll put this over here in the corner. Let's start with the traveler's notebook first. So this is the clear cover on cover that I purchased that will go around this. Cool. Okay. This is really pretty. That was a really snug fit. So this is called the mist cover. I picked the white edge. Your option is white or gold. I happen to pick white. And this is going to take the place of my traveler's notebook. So let me just show you really quick what this one looks like. How about a blank one? So this is what the blank traveler's notebook looks like with the horizontal layout. And then I'll show you how I'm using it. So I keep track of my meals, my vitamins, and then I have a specific vitamin that I need to take once a week. Over here, I keep track of my sleep. And then I've been keeping track of how tired I've been and eye drops that I've started to take. So that's what that looks like. And so that's what this is gonna be. And they're sent the same size. Okay, so now let's flip through this. So this is a goal breakdown. I don't know if you can see that. Here's the yearly tracker. Bruce, come on. Bruce, come on over. So this is Q1 priorities for January, February, March. And then here is the vertical breakdown for the 3 months. Here's Q2, Q3, and Q4. That's interesting. I don't know what I would use that for in a health tracker. That's something to think about. Here is the monthly layout. So there's December, January, and then so on. So let's go to the weekly. Okay, so here's January of 2026. And then here's the last week of December, and then the first week of January. So to compare this to the Traveler Standard, and then they both had the blank. And the reason why I want to try the Sterling Ink N1 is with this one, you get two booklets. This one is all in one. And the back are blank pages. So here is December, last week of December, then the first week of January of 2026. And then here are blank pages. I'm going to put the clear cover on cover over the, is this the N1? Where is my notes? Yes. So here's the inside. This is the, I think I got this from another traveler's notebook, like a dupe from Amazon, which I'm just using the insides. In here I have stickers. This is a folder that I made with some wrapping paper that my sister gave me last year, and I haven't used it. And then there's some pictures. So that's Bruce. So that's what he looked like when we first adopted him. You can kind of see how dark his eyes are around his eyes, because now it has gone white around his eyes. That's Angus Rose. And then there's Bruce with Kit Kat trying to scare him. But my thought was, because I didn't want the string, you know, in between the book like this, though I imagine, I guess you could do that. Okay. But you can see the string inside the book. Since I didn't want to do that, I read in the Facebook group for Sterling Ink that what you could do is get the clear cover on cover, slide that in first so that the string is, you know, inside the plastic clear cover on cover. And then at that point, you would install the cover on cover like that. Let me do the other side and I'll be right back. Okay, so here it is. I had a little struggle getting it in. So it is a soft cover, the N1 journal planner. It's soft, so you can kind of see, but the string is between the clear cover on cover and the book. So hopefully you can see that. There it is. So you can see the string back here. So I need to play with it a little bit to try to get the string along the spine and not in the back. But now my pages are kind of free and not interrupted by the string. I kind of like that. Okay, so now let me put this back on. So not too bad. Not much of an overhang, and it only has a folder as well as that clear, I don't know what they call this, but you know, you can slip in stickers, money, whatever you want. But that's this one. So let me set this guy aside over here. Then the next one I want to show you is the A5. So that's what this one looks like. Now this one's going to replace my Hobonichi cousin. Oh, that's nice. So I guess this is sort of a pencil board for the A5. How pretty. Okay, so let me get the clear plastic off of this and I'll be right back. So the one that I picked, once again, this one's called the Tweed with the white edge instead of the gold. This is the A5 vertical full year common planner, 520 total pages, 368 blank pages. And I'm looking forward to using this one because it won't have writing on the bottom. Okay, if you compare it to the Hobonichi cousin. So let me just, so here's a random Hobonichi cousin, two pages. So you can see that there are quotes on the bottom, which this obviously doesn't have, and in the dates on top. So let's go back. So this is also soft. So here's a gold breakdown on two pages. Here is your yearly tracker. And then here's quarter one, same thing. That was in the weekly layout for the N1. Here's Q3. Q4. Then we come to the monthly layout. Okay, so the layout should be similar or the same as this one. Here is January 2026. And then the weekly layout here. So let me show you the weekly layout for the cousin to compare. Let me try and find you a blank one. So here they are side by side. It's a Monday start. Sunday's over here. And I don't mind that. I prefer a Monday start. So here's the last week of December, first week of January 2026. And then we start the blank daily pages. And I appreciate this because that way I am not tied to try to fill in that page. Or if I want to journal more, let's pretend for January 1 and I want to go into January 2. January 2. If it was a normal dated page, I would just be stuck with this. And I can write as much or as little as I want. And I do appreciate that. And my intent with this is to treat it like my cousin, like this. So hopefully it should. I haven't seen, I should watch more videos to see if the binding will hold up compared to a cousin. But I plan to use this like I do here. So just a quick look on my, so this is the weekly layout, where I put down the task for the day with stickers and washi tape. And then my daily pages at least with this one for this past year, has been filled with Bruce, who is our English Bulldog, as well as my mom. So a lot of family pictures. You know, sometimes when we buy something, I'll tape it in. Bruce. Stamps that I've collected. And then if I don't have anything that I want to put down, I put down cuttings that I did for magazines. So this is what I sort of plan to do in here, except again, because it's dated. So for instance, where did that flower go? On this day, on April 27, I didn't have anything to say. So I put this picture down on this day. In here, if I don't have anything that I want to say for April 27, I just may skip that day altogether and then write something on April 28 because something happened. So that's what I'm looking forward to in here. And let's try out to see how it will fit in a Hobonichi cover. So even though I'm not using the Techos for 2025, because I own a lot of Hobonichi covers, that's what I plan to use. So here's my Cookie Monster A5. So let's see if the Sterling Ink A5 will fit into. Slides in really nice. And it's just for funsies, because this is the way I would use it anyways, is to slide both covers, the back and front, into the journal itself. Fits perfectly. Really nice. Cookie Monster's dirty. But there you go. Fits. Pretty happy with that. Okay, so let me pull them back out. And that is a look of my Sterling Ink purchases. This is the A5 Full Year Vertical Common Planner. And this is the N1 Horizontal Compact Full Year. And this will fit into the A5 Hobonichi cover, as well as this fitting into my traveler's notebook. So if you liked the video, give it a thumbs up. If you didn't, give it a thumbs down. Subscribe if you'd like to see what I plan to do next year with these guys. I'm looking forward to using both these planners. But other than that, that's it. Thanks for watching. I'll talk to you guys later. Bye!